If you don't like the weather, wait 5 minutes, it'll change.
Boy, isn't that the truth? But for Minnesotans waiting for spring, snow and ice, man, we wish this didn't happen.
Yeah, it's like changing for the worse right now, let's be honest. We are talking about a slow and messy commute this morning. Just one of the problems that we are seeing on our interstates this morning, one after another. We're going to get to the roads for you coming up. But first, let's get to meteorologist Ken Barlow and a check of the forecast. I guess the good news is the system's moved out of here.
Yeah, now it becomes the traffic story. You can see in the police flashing there, the glare on the on the roadways, and that's the big problem this morning. Lots of glare, lots of ice. As far as the Twin Cities are concerned, we picked up a total of less than a half an inch officially at Twin Cities International. So, in other words, when you look ahead, when you look back a year from now and you say, remember how big that storm was? Officially in the record books, it'll say a half an inch. None of this other stuff will be there. 19 inches on I-Santee this morning. Monticello, 14 plus. Plymouth, Maple Grove, the northwest suburbs generally about 7 inches. Here are some more stunning totals, and I mean stunning as far as a cutoff is concerned. Zimmerman 11, Coon Rapids over 9, right 10 miles apart. Watertown 6.5, 10 miles south in Waconia, a half an inch. I haven't ever seen that, such a sharp cutoff. Hmm. We'll talk more about that and the good news. 70 in the forecast when we come back.
We're going to hear you say that over and over and over again this morning. Okay, folks, here's a look at the True View map. And you see a lot of red out there, and that is because, as again Ken's been saying, snow north of the metro causing major problems. In South Metro, it's sort of an icy, wet road that's causing problems for you. Let's take a look right now. 35E at 494 in Mendota Heights. We've been watching this one. You see you've got a car kind of slid right off there, still blocking one, even two lanes, causing a major slowdown in this area, Mendota Heights, and they didn't even get a lot of snow in that area. Let's check out 35E at Randolph. This is a big-time slowdown, and you can see the glare there, the reflection on the road. We're talking some really slick conditions. And now let's check 94 and 280. 94 and 280, we've got a problem here. We have one or two lanes that are blocked, two lanes that are blocked right here, so traffic squeezing down to one lane. So it is a big time slowdown for you out there today, folks. If you can, you're definitely going to want to leave yourself some extra time as we look at from a different perspective of what we just showed you there on 94
and
280.
This is an area, I don't know if you recall, in the last storm where we had a lot of problems. Semis couldn't make it up the road, and so I don't know if you remember this, but around 9, 10 o'clock, 8 o'clock in the morning during the last storm, they actually closed a stretch of 94. They had to salt it and just get the vehicles out of there so they could figure out what to do.
Just enough of an incline to cause problems out there. We want to show you a live look from a map here at the road conditions, sort of outstate Minnesota, give you an idea what we're talking about if you're headed up north. Travel very difficult. You can see light purple, the color you see here, that's considered difficult. Light blue, considered fair conditions. Green is considered good driving conditions. And I will say, I looked at this map, I don't know, about a couple of hours ago, and there was some dark purple on there, which meant extremely dangerous conditions, and we don't see that. So that is good news, I guess, if you could call it that. Things are getting a little better.
Well, check out this snowfall in Edina overnight. It really came down at quite a clip. The snow is over this morning, but the headaches for drivers, not even close to being over. Our Catherine Johnson is live in Fridley, where several inches fell overnight. Fridley is where we are seeing that jackknife that was, that semi that was jackknifed this morning, Catherine.
Yeah, Megan, and about half an hour ago, tow truck operators were able to get it out and get it back on the road. But I want to show you what's happening here on the side streets, because you're not only going to be dealing with problems on the highways and interstates, you'll be lucky if you can get out of your neighborhood. These are our tire tracks. We haven't seen a plow come through here on the side streets in Fridley yet this morning, and we've been out here since about 4. I would say there's a good 4 inches on the ground here just on the streets, so it's going to be tough to get out of your driveway if you're driving a small car. As for the bigger trucks here, this is 694, still a tow truck left over here on the side from that jackknifed semi, but they were able to get the semi off and on the way. Traffic's still moving pretty slowly, and you'll see that slight incline that we keep talking about. That's what the bigger, heavier trucks are going to have a problem with this morning, because there is a a thick and slick sheet of ice on the roads. And the further north you go, the worse it gets. We're still seeing dozens of accidents, though, all throughout the metro. We were there overnight after a car took out a light post in St. Paul. And this is the kind of stuff we're expecting to see a lot of this morning. So take it slow on this morning commute. And even though MnDOT was out in full force last night, we saw five plows driving side by side, working to treat our roads in the middle of April. We've got snow blowers out, too. Talking with people yesterday, they told us they knew well enough not to put their equipment away just yet. It's just pretty strange and frustrating to people we were talking to overnight. Just this keeps happening. We keep seeing 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 inches of snow throughout Minnesota. And then a few days later, 60 degrees, 70 degree temperatures. But the people we're talking to overnight are pretty optimistic. And we'll give you a look at that coming up in the next half hour. For now, live in Fridley, Catherine Johnson, 5 Eyewitness News.
You know, Catherine, it is in times like these where people like to go to social media, maybe vent, talk about it, kind of give them a forum. Well, here's what some of our viewers are saying about the snow. Stephanie posted on our Facebook page in southwest Minnesota, they got a dusting. And from her perspective, she's still wearing her sandals. Yeah. While Elizabeth says she plowed her Annandale driveway in the afternoon, but the snow just kept on falling. And Tammy in North Branch, what you're seeing here, this is her grill covered in snow. She got 15 inches at her home and had this to say, snow, snow, go away. All caps there in the away. Go away. There are a lot of school delays this morning. You can see them right now scrolling at the bottom of your screen. You can also find the full list on our website, kstp.com. Make sure to stay with us here. We'll get you updated on any school changes that are out there. And we definitely know the road conditions are going to be changing all morning long. Keep it right here, 5 Eyewitness News.